All right, the last two properties are the negative exponent and the power raised to a power. All right, for the negative exponent, all that this means is that anytime you see a base raised to a negative exponent, you need to move it or take the reciprocal of it technically, but I like to just say move it, all right? So in this example, a to the negative n. Technically, a to the negative n is unhappy where it's at, so you need to move it, and the only two places to move it are in the top or the bottom. This a to the negative n exists in the top, because technically anything is over 1. And so, since it's in the top, and it's unhappy in the top because it's negative there, I need to move it to the bottom, and this is what's happening. I'm taking the reciprocal, so I flipped it, and so then it becomes 1 over a to the n, and it's positive there because it's happy when I move it, all right? So let's practice this topic, because this is pretty straightforward. If I do this example, b squared divided by b to the fifth, the first thing I know, it's a base divided by base, so I have to subtract the powers. So this equals b to the negative third. Now, b to the negative third technically sits atop 1, so it is unhappy where it's at, because it's raised to a negative power. The way I remember that is negative people are typically unhappy, so I have to move it to make them positive and happy. So I have to put this in the basement of a fraction. So it becomes b to the positive 3. It becomes happy because I moved it, and now it exists underneath 1. And my final answer is 1 over b to the third. Another way to think about it, b to the negative third was in the top of a fraction. It was over 1. So because it was in the top, I needed to move it to the bottom, and when I move it, it becomes happy. Same process. So I'm going to try this one, negative 3 raised to the negative third. And then I'm going to have you try 2 to the negative third, and then I'm going to give you one more example to practice before moving on to the next power. So negative 3 raised to the negative third, again, this base raised to the negative power tells me that it's unhappy where it's at. And right now it currently sits over 1. It always will. It's not written usually, but you can write it when you need to take the reciprocal of it. So what I'm going to do is put this negative 3 in the basement, because I had to move it because it was unhappy where it was at. And when I move it, it becomes happy, so it's no longer negative. It becomes a positive 3, and it sits below a 1. So it becomes the reciprocal, and when you flip it, it turns from negative to positive. So I am done. Go ahead and try 2 raised to the negative 3. Pause this video and see if you can simplify this one correctly. At this point, you should have paused the video, and if you remember, this is technically over 1, so you have to move it to the basement of a fraction, and when you do that, it becomes 2 raised to the positive 3, because when you move it, it becomes happy, and it's below 1. So you should have gotten 1 over 2 to the third. Now, one more thing I just want to talk about quickly is, what happens if you have a fraction like x cubed over y to the negative 2. It's the same thought process. Now my unhappy base exists in the bottom. It still needs to be moved, and the only other place it can be moved is to the top, because again, it's two options, top or bottom. So it exists in the bottom. It's unhappy in the bottom. So now I need to put it to the top to make it happy. So to simplify this, it becomes x cubed y squared with a positive 2. All over 1. Alright, so go ahead and try this example, and I'm going to try to make it a little bit more challenging. Let's say I have x cubed over y to the negative 2. Well, I got to change it a little bit. Let's say it's x to the 5th over y to the negative 4th z squared. Go ahead and simplify that. Move the one piece that needs to be moved into the correct place. So pause that and simplify that. At this point, you should have paused the video, and if you notice, the only thing that is unhappy where it's at right now is this, y to the negative 4th. It's in the bottom. The only place to move it is to the top, and then it becomes happy because I moved it. So my final answer, and what you should have gotten, is x to the 5th, now y to the 4th, both in the numerator, and the z squared in the denominator was happy where it was at because it was positive. So this sits over z squared, and I'm done. If you didn't get that, please raise your hand so I can come talk to you about it. Now, let's move on to the final property, and it's the power of a power. Or, in other words, when a base with a power is raised to another power, you multiply those powers. So power raised to power, you multiply the exponents. It's pretty straightforward, and it gets a little bit more complicated if there's multiple things within the parentheses. But to start it off, I'm just going to show you what happens if there's one thing in the parentheses. So I'm going to do this example. I have y to the negative third raised to the negative fourth. So the first thing, I'm going to show you the math that's happening. Remember, power raised to a power, you multiply the power. So now it becomes y to the negative 3 times negative 4. So my final answer, negative 3 times negative 4 is 12, so I have y to the 12th, and I'm done. Go ahead and try x squared raised to the 8th. Pause the video and see if you can simplify that. At this point, you should have paused the video. The first step, you can show your math if you so please. It's x to the 2 times 8, power raised to power, you multiply the powers. And then finally, x to the 2 times 8 becomes x to the 16. You should have gotten x to the 16. Now, let's talk about two situations where this becomes a little bit more complicated. All right, if you notice, these three examples, there's multiple things within the parentheses, all right? So this power that sits outside of the parentheses for all that interacts with every piece that's inside that. And I'm going to show you how it does interact. You got to just take it step by step to arrive at the answer. Same thing down here. If you notice, there's multiple things within the parentheses. So that power is going to go to everything that exists inside the parentheses. All right. And again, please don't get discouraged if you're working through this, because there's a few different ways usually to arrive at the same answer, and you just have to get used to applying the properties, and once that happens, this process becomes a little bit more easier. So, the first thing first, whenever you're dealing with parentheses, is the question I'll ask, and I'm going to do this example. The question I ask myself, is there anything inside the parentheses that I can apply a rule to? I like to say, is there anything inside the parentheses that I can clean up? In this case, the only rule that exists is this z raised to the 0. I know that anything raised to the 0 is 1. So whenever I see this situation to start off a problem, I just cross it out. It goes away. It becomes 1, but technically anything times 1 is itself, so I don't need to write it. So it just goes away. Now, there's no other properties to apply within the parentheses. Base times base doesn't work because the bases are different. There is no division. And so now I can apply the power property of power of a product, all right? So this negative 2, this power, and this is the first or second step technically I cleaned up on the inside of the parentheses by crossing out the z to the 0. So the second step then, and I'll write 2 here for the second step, is that this power interacts with everything inside the parentheses. And so I'm going to write this math in my next step to show you my thought process. This 6 is just a number, so it becomes 6 raised to the negative 2, and I'm going to do that math as I would do with any number, all right? There's no adding or subtracting or multiplying of powers necessary for that. It just becomes 6 raised to the negative 2. X now, I do have to apply the product property. Power raised to a power, so the negative 6 raised to negative 2, they multiply, so it becomes negative 6 times negative 2. And then y becomes negative 7 times negative 2 as well. That is just my thought process written out in the format. The next step then is I'm going to start doing this math. Now the first thing I have to consider is that 6 is raised to a negative exponent. If that is ever the case, it needs to be moved to be happy, all right? So I can do this now or I can do it at the end. It doesn't matter. I'm going to do it now. So I'm going to take this. It's unhappy where it's at. And technically, it's in a numerator because all of this is over 1. Let me move down my fourth step a little bit. All of this is over 1. So I need to move this into the denominator to join that 1. So my fourth step, the first thing I'm going to write is in the denominator, there's going to be a 6, but now it's raised to a positive 2, because again, whenever I move a negative exponent, it becomes happy, and it becomes positive. It was in the numerator, I need to put it in the denominator. Let's see how the powers of my exponent, or the powers of my variables play out, all right? Because again, if they're negative, I also have to move them, but if they're positive, they stay where they're at. So x to the negative 6 times negative 2. Negative 6 times negative 2 becomes a positive 12. So far, it's positive. Don't have to move it. Let's do the y's. Y to the negative 7 times negative 2 becomes y to the positive 14. So that one's positive 2. I don't have to move it. They stay in the numerator. If they were negative, I'd have to move them to the denominator, but they're not. So finally, to clean this up even more, to simplify it even more, I'm actually going to do this math. All right. So if you remember back to 6 to the negative 2, moved it to the denominator. Now it becomes x to the 12th, y to the 14th, over 6 squared, which is 36. And I am done. So at this point, I want you to try these two on your own. I will tell you right now, there's nothing to clean up within the parentheses, all right? So this power just interacts with all of these. So this 3 interacts with that 4, that interacts with the x, the y, and the z. All right, 4 you just treat as a number, so it's going to become 4 cubed. And the same thing over here. This negative 2 interacts with that 7, that x, and that y. But please remember, if you have negative variables, you have to move them. So go ahead and pause your video and try these on your own. Pause the video and try these two on your own. I did the left one over here completely. So number 2 is my answer. Step 2 is my answer. So check your answer with mine. If you did not get that, please raise your hand so we can talk about it, all right? I'm going to walk through number 2, but hopefully you have this one all completed as well. I've done my first step. I've distributed that power into the parentheses. I've rewrote each piece of math that exists. Now it becomes 7 raised to the negative 2. It becomes x raised to the 1 times negative 2. And it becomes y to the negative 2 times negative 2. My second step is I have to deal with negative exponents and I have to do some math. So, the first thing, this 7 is unhappy where it's at. Technically, this is over 1, so my new step, that 7 is going to go into the basement. It's going to become 7 raised to the positive 2 when I move it. So, hopefully that's something you did. Now I'm going to deal with the math of these variables. X raised to the 1 times negative 2 becomes x to the negative 2. That should jump out at you because it's negative. Y, negative 2, so y raised to the negative 2 times negative 2 becomes a positive 4. That is happy where it's at because it's positive. So my final step, this piece, also needs to be moved. All right? So my final answer is y to the 4th over x squared, and I'm actually going to do this math. 7 squared is 49. Put the number first, 49. Times x squared on the basement. This was unhappy. I moved it. It becomes happy in the basement. If you didn't get that for your answer, please raise your hand again so we can talk about it. Now to finish off these notes, I'm going to do one more example where within the parentheses it's division. All right. So my first thought, I'm going to do this one and ask you to do this one. We're not going to do these two. All right. So my first thought within the parentheses, is there anything to clean up? And that answer is no. So then I distribute this power into everything. All right? I'm going to show my math. It becomes 3 cubed times a to the negative 4 times 3 in my powers, all over b to the 7 times 3. Remember, power to power, you multiply the powers. Second step is to actually do that math now. 3 cubed, remember, because 3 is just a number, so the power interacts with that just as normal. 3 cubed becomes 27. A, so negative 4 times 3 is a negative 12. And then over B, 7 times 3 is a 21. All right? One thing should jump out at you, so I'm not quite done yet. This is negative. So it needs to be moved to the basement to become positive. So my final answer is 27 over b to the 21, a to the positive 12. Go ahead and try your example and check your work with mine when you're done. So please pause the video. At this point, you should have paused the video and tried this one. Here's my final answer. If you did not get this, please raise your hand so I can come check your work.